Do you go back and forth for countless hours trying to find a meeting time that works for everyone? It's exhausting. I partnered with Calendly to show you a free tool to eliminate all that back and forth. Let's dive in. If you're new to Calendly, you'll want to create a free account using the link in the top of the screen or below in the video description. To begin, I need to connect my calendars with Calendly by selecting availability on the left-hand navigation panel. Then I'll select calendar settings. You'll then select the type of calendar that you wish to connect and follow the guided prompts. Rest assured, anyone viewing your availability will only see open time slots, not specific calendar details. Calendly supports up to 6 connected calendars with a paid plan or 1 calendar with a free plan. Calendly will check all of these in real time to prevent conflicts, hiding events marked as busy to avoid double bookings. When someone schedules a meeting with you, it's automatically added to your chosen calendar. And on Calendly, under Meetings, you can also make manual adjustments to your availability under the default schedule. This can be changed based off of your work hours for specific days. You can also go to the calendar view to select specific days where you want to make adjustments. This is a great feature if you're going on vacation and want to show yourself as unavailable, as these customizations will override your connected calendars. Now that you've set a schedule for yourself, you can create different meeting types for easy scheduling. By selecting new event type, I can easily add my event details, including duration, as well as selecting multiple options for location, including connecting my Calendly account to Zoom for virtual meetings, meaning that when someone schedules a meeting with me, the Zoom details will automatically be sent out, saving me time. You can also tailor your availability to determine how far in advance someone can schedule a meeting with you, as well as how much advance notice you need prior to that meeting starting. Additional options could include adding buffer times before or after your meetings, as well as asking questions that might help prepare you for the meeting that's scheduled. And if you're providing a service, you can even connect your Calendly account with Stripe or PayPal for easy one-click payments. You can also create one-off meeting links or group invites, and my favorite, a meeting poll. For advanced users, Calendly offers options like round-robin scheduling, which balances meeting loads among team members. For seamless scheduling, I want to add the 30-minute sync I created to my email signature. I'll select copy link. Now anyone can schedule a meeting with me directly from my email. No more back and forth required. And if you want users to have the option to select what type of event type they would like to schedule with you, you can instead use this link by clicking on Settings. Copy link will then share all of your event types, allowing someone to select which event type they want to schedule on your calendar. Sick of meeting no-shows or sending out the same reminder details prior to meetings? Calendly workflows simplify and automate your scheduling-related tasks. Calendly offers pre-designed templates for common use cases, like reminders and follow-ups, both through text and email. Alternatively, you could create a custom workflow tailored to your specific needs. Let me show you an example of how you can automate a meeting reminder and request that the invitee reconfirm your meeting. Start by selecting Add Workflow. I could start by renaming my workflow if I wish, and then I'll select which event types I want this workflow to apply to. You could either choose to select all your events or just pick specific ones. For example, I might choose to have 2 email reminder workflows, a more formal one for an external project consultation where I'm asking the attendee to reconfirm the meeting, as well as a workflow for internal meetings like a group sync or project kickoff. This might be a more informal email reminder, and I don't want them to reconfirm the meeting, and I might have less information in it. So I'll select the event that I want this workflow to apply to and click Apply. Next, I'll choose an event milestone which will trigger my workflow. A common trigger could be when a new event is booked, or in this case, before an event starts. I can also choose the specific time I want this to be sent out prior to an event starting, whether that's days, hours, or minutes. Next, I'll customize my email. Here, I can customize my messaging, which could include adding variables such as the event name, organizer name, an event time or date, as well as location information. Since I've added my Zoom virtual meeting information and connected that to my Calendly account, that will automatically appear here in my reminder email. It also might include the questions and answers that the user filled out when booking the meeting. I can customize this by adding my own text or adding and deleting variables, making it very easy to have a customized reminder email. And finally, I'll have the option to include a reconfirm button. I could also include cancellation and rescheduling links, as well as a cancellation policy if applicable. You can use multiple workflows for comprehensive automation, such as combining pre-meeting reminders with post-meeting thank yous or follow-ups. A helpful tip is to leverage SMS and use text message reminders for high-priority meetings, or if you're utilizing Calendly to book appointments for services. By reducing manual efforts, Calendly workflows can save you valuable time, as well as elevate your professionalism. Another benefit is you'll never have to worry about forgetting to send that meeting reminder or follow up. I am relatively new to using browser extensions, but I have found that they can certainly help with my productivity. And the Calendly browser extension has saved me a lot of time and improved my multitasking effectiveness. If you're unfamiliar with what a browser extension is, think of it as an app that lives on your internet browser that allows you to access something without switching tabs. Calendly has browser extensions for Chrome, Edge, and Firefox. Once I have downloaded the extension, in this case on Edge, I can access Calendly easily wherever I need it the most. In this case, selecting some dates and times that would work for scheduling a meeting, and then quickly sharing it with call-in details with the person I'm speaking with. I can also quickly view and manage my meetings, including canceling them, quickly rescheduling a meeting to catch a flight, as well as marking no-shows and booking additional meetings with clients. You can ensure Calendly is always where you need it to be by downloading the mobile app. Here you can get alerts when new meetings are scheduled, access your meeting contacts, as well as share your availability on the go. Why waste time when you don't need to? Utilizing these features within Calendly will save you time, increase accuracy, and allow you to be more productive this year. Let me know in the comments what some of your favorite Calendly productivity features are. Thanks for watching.